human and would provide the masses with a model of physical beauty. Now, we'll come to that later. Excavations at the Indus Valley showed pots of coal that women used to adorn their eyes. So right from very ancient civilization. So how would you describe a beautiful face? The concepts of beauty. Each one's concepts of beauty is different. Each one looks at beauty differently. So there can't be one fixed thing that, okay, I think this is beautiful. If I say oval is beautiful, some people may say square looks extremely nice if the jawline is good and, you know, very delineated properly. Then you say that, okay, square face is good. So it's in the eyes of the beholder. But generally, by the normal consensus, this is bilaterally symmetrical. Though, we'll go further. I think most of us don't have symmetry on both sides of our face. They're not identical, they're not mirror image. So if we were to just hold a hand right like this and look at one part of our face and then look at the other, you'll see that there is a difference. Either one side is a little lower, or, you know, the eyes and the eyebrows are differently arched, and you'll see that there is very rarely a symmetry between the two sides. Horizontal facial thirds. When we come for acne, or they've come to ask about Botox, or they have come because their face and more tired. So they come with all these requests. So what we have to do is do a facial analysis or an assessment and tell them these are the areas where we can help you. So to make it easy for us, we divide it into three parts. From the hairline to the eyebrow, middle of the eyebrow. From the middle of the eyebrow to the end of the nose, that is the second third. And the lower third is to be from the nose to the end of the chin. Vertical lines also. This is more, I think, Dr. Srinivas's subject where he knows how to carve it. But this is what the rule of fifths is. You see how it is. So we know which part is lacking, where to put the material when we are doing our assessment. The OG curve, which are not so deep, they say please fill that up with a dermal filler. So what happens, they've got good cheeks, so the whole face becomes round here when you fill this. Take away all the lines. Only when they do not compliment you or the taking away from your beauty, only then we touch. Otherwise these curves are very necessary. It's plumped up a little bit, but this comes in very handy when people are a little complex about their lips. Or in the aging process where the lip, where you lose volume from the whole face, the fat pads are lost. Similarly, the lips become very thin, they become dry. So there's a shriveled kind of a look. So by putting hyaluronic acid, which is the dermal filler content, we are hydrating the lips, we're taking out the crinkles. We need not pout the lips. That is when people ask for it. But you can put in a little volume. So these are just, this is for my medical lecture actually. Now the inversion of beauty. This is very beautiful to understand. Volume loss and muscular hyperactivity are two major components of the aging process that together contribute to the stigma of aging. You know that the triangles, you can see both the triangles. In youth, the lower angle is the chin and those two are ends of the forehead. Now as we age, gravity, the pull of gravity, the detachment from the remain, you know, from the attached where it is detached from the underlying surfaces, and aging, your lifestyle, everything, and you have this jowls appearing, and there is a little temporal hollowing, the fat pads are lost, so then this becomes an inverted triangle. So that is the aging process where the triangle gets completely. I never believe that right from nature, this is what we use in aesthetics, but this face or any of our faces, if you see the year to year width and compare it with the length of our face, it is 1 to 1.6. If you take your upper arm to your forearm is 1 to 1.6. It is unbelievable. So this is something to think about, and it's something that, you know, a little added knowledge. It's very exciting to know that anything in nature is also 1 is to 1.6. These are some more pictures. The universal radiation come from the medial side, and these are ideal lips. Facial shapes, I was just telling you, oval is considered the most beautiful. This is a consensus taken from all over the world. But we know that even in our own Bollywood, we have so many faces that are a little squarish and still very beautiful. Round faces, I don't know. I don't think they are, but there is a lot that one can do, explain. And there is the oblong face, and there is the heart-shaped face. Said in all planes, it should be there. Nose, which is quite straight, well-defined tip, and a good projection, with almond-shaped nostrils. This is a tip in, because the texture is also important, free of wrinkles, folds, and furrows. The male, the attractive male face, overhanging horizontal brow with minimal arch, ladies, want the nose and mouth, lower jaw, is usually squarish, squared lower face with defined jawline. Of people where we reverse, so we do the half face and we take a picture, and then it's usually, it may seem exaggerated, but it isn't so. We know our lips droop, the happy mouth becomes sad because the angle of the mouth turns downwards, the eyebrow, the whole thing, there's a downward move. So for all we know that we may be eating, I say, and drink it within 2 to 3 minutes of making it. You can put whatever greens are there. When we give a recipe, we tell our clients, please don't get stressed. You open your fridge and there's no palak on that day. There is no, coriander leaves. Of antioxidant and bring down the free radicals in our body. Our change in lifestyle does it. Eat frequent small meals, less oil and sugar, increase your BMR. Exercising, a little cardio with a little stretching. We all know, I'm just repeating, going through it quickly. Increased protein intake. Of course, again, depending on your medical status. Lifestyle and exercise. Aim is to exercise regularly. Include a combination of cardio, toning, and mental relaxation. Increase the heart rate, thus increasing supply of oxygen to all organs, including the skin, which is our largest organ, and the last to receive nutrients and blood. Exercise to suit your age, weight, medical problem, and lifestyle. Very important. Just because a neighbor can do 100 Surya Namaskar, if you have a backache, you definitely can't do even 10. It's very detrimental. So it's very important to see what kind of body, what your problems are, and then choose your activity. But there has to be lifestyle nutraceuticals. I just told you.